Hey guys, we're gonna start something new. I should maybe move to this side where I don't have a planet growing out of my face. Okay. Yeah, so I figured we'd start something new. I've spent a lot of time in the car, so I figured maybe I could start doing car vlogs so we can get some chat time in between videos because I feel like we don't really get to talk all that much. Oh, I look like shit today. Okay, never mind that. So, and I think I'm getting sick again. Thanks to somebody who visits my house frequently and has a sick child. I'm not gonna say any names. If you watch my videos, you know who you are. I just thought we would chat. So, topic of the day: work cramping my creative style. Like, if I didn't have to go to a job, I would just do nothing but create. Like, I would be making videos, I'd be building my little DIYs, my furniture, just the shit that I like to do. Like, honestly, when I'm creating something is when I am at my most content, my most happy. I feel like I'm productive, I'm doing something, whether it's editing a video or filming a video or doing a makeup look or doing a client's makeup, I'm creating something. And I feel like work really just sucks the fun out of life. Like, I'm probably not the only person that feels that way, but it just is killing me, and I need to find a way to not have to work anymore so I can just live my life and be a free person to create and just, you know, live my life. Oh, and I got new glasses, guys. I don't know how you feel about them. I feel like they're okay. I'm not in love with them, but I don't really like glasses on me per se, but I figured they do work for covering up the ugly on ugly days when I'm not wearing makeup. A little bit, they hide it a little bit. But yeah, I'm off today. I'm going to my mother's. We're probably gonna go do a little shopping, and I feel like there's something on my lip, like skin. What is that? yeah, so that's what we're gonna do. I need to get like some kind of sticky pad to put this vlogging camera on because it's killing my arm. But yeah, what are your guys' thoughts on that? I feel like, I don't know, sometimes when I'm working a lot, I just have no energy left to do anything creative, and it just really pisses me off because I have so many ideas and so much stuff that I want to do, and it just sometimes doesn't happen because I don't have time or I'm too tired. So, I don't know, I just need to get my life in order. Like, money is, you need it to survive, but I feel like it's not everything, and I feel like it's not the most important thing. So if I have enough money to pay my bills and to live comfortably, I'm cool. Like, as long as I can make my art, and by art I mean anything that I'm creating. Art is anything. Art can be an outfit you make, it can be, you know, a makeup look, it can be a painting, it can be photography, whatever it is, I just want to create. And I was watching I've been watching Casey Neistat a lot lately, and he is a YouTuber. I'm sure you guys have probably seen him. He has a big channel. But he's like a filmmaker, and he said something pretty profound the other day. Like, I don't remember what it was. It was like last week or something, but he said that perfection will actually get in the way of you being productive. He said it in a much more eloquent way. I can't remember exactly how he said it, but basically the pursuit of perfection can sometimes stand in your way of like actually creating things and actually going out there and doing something. Like, there are so many times that I've wanted to do a project or film something, or, you know, just start something that would have been probably pretty amazing even if it wasn't perfect, but I didn't do it because I was afraid of it not being perfect. And that's such bullshit. Like, I stand in my way more times than not, in my own way, and I could have been, you know, way more productive in getting shit done. And that's a pretty good way to look at it. Like, maybe we shouldn't be in the pursuit of perfection, because I mean, that's not realistic. Nobody's perfect. So I'm gonna try, not as a resolution but a New Year's goal, to just get out there more and just start creating more and stop letting shit get in my way. Because like I said, that's when I'm most happy. There are two scenarios in my life that bring me the most joy, and that is being with my family and friends and just, you know, having a good time. And by friends, I really don't have a ton of friends. Actually, I should just say family, and anybody who is a friend that I've known for a really long time, I would consider them family. So that and creating. And I feel like I kind of get that from my mom because, and my dad actually, they're both like artistic. My mom, she's really good at like drawing cartoons and like that kind of stuff. And my dad's really good at drawing like realistic type things. So they're both really artsy. And I, for the longest time, I always thought like, oh, I don't have any artistic ability. And then I'm like, wait a minute, everything can be art. So then I realized, yeah, I guess I can, I kind of am artistic and I can be in lots of different ways. But it's been hella cold here lately. I have the heat on right now. It says it's 54 degrees outside, which is pretty cold for Vegas. I did manage to get my morning skincare routine filmed this morning. And, well, the clip of me actually doing the routine. So like the intro and everything else, I still have to film. But again, I'm striving for great, not perfection. So even if it's not perfect, I'm still gonna do it. I'm still gonna put content out, and I'm just gonna see where life takes me. But I have a Generation Beauty coming up at the end of the month. I'm gonna go to that. I've never been to it before, but I joined Ipsy OS and they gave me a free ticket to go, so I can't turn down a free ticket. All I have to do is just get myself out there. And I'm bringing my little sister and my sister-in-law. They're not going to Generation Beauty, but they're just going with me. And they're probably just going to hang out at the hotel while I'm doing that. And I've never been before, so I don't really know what it's all about. I don't know what you do there, but it should be fun. I'm excited. And, of course, I'll bring you guys with me and show you as much as I can. But I just kind of want to open the lines of communication. Like, do you guys ever feel stifled by, like, work and daily responsibilities and just like grown-up shit that nobody wants to deal with? I just want to be free. That's all I can say. I just want to be free to come and go as I please and to create and just be myself. Like, I feel honestly like I enjoy working with the people that I work with. They're all cool people, but like, I just have a really big problem with structure and like having to be somewhere at a certain time and having to, you know, like, I don't like it. I just want to be able to come and go as I please. And I know that probably sounds stupid, but it's how I feel. I don't want to show up at fucking whatever early in the morning for things. I just want to be able to come and go as I please and be productive. And I feel like I'm honestly more productive when I don't have, like, I mean, I know in life you have deadlines and you have priorities, but when I don't have like a seriously, completely set schedule, or when I don't have people telling me where I have to be and when I have to be there, I feel like I'm way more productive. And I'm way harder on myself work-wise, like when I'm doing my own shit, than any boss or any company could ever be on me. So it's not that I don't have work ethic. It's not that I'm not a hard worker, because I am. Even like at work, I want to do the best that I can. I want to do things the way they're supposed to be done. I want things to be done the right way. So it's not like I'm just like some slacker. I just don't like to do shit when I don't want to do it. But that's all. So yeah, I want to, oh, back on the I'm gonna get off here soon because I know I've probably been like rambling on for way too long. But getting back on my healthy kick. I've been doing my, and it's not gonna be a kick this time, guys. It's gonna be like a lifestyle change. Doing my smoothies in the morning. I figured out a brilliant way to make my kale easy to put in my smoothie and make it where I don't waste it. So, like, cause it's a lot of times it'll go bad before I can use it. So I will share that with you in another video. But yeah, I've been doing my smoothies. I've really been enjoying my spinach salads. I've discovered protein pasta, which is pretty epic. I've really been enjoying that. And I'm gonna probably do some food videos. I don't know. I'm gonna try to. I'm not like a chef or anything, and I'm not really that good of a cook. So, but I know what I like, and I just make simple things that aren't like too hard to make. Laura in the Kitchen. I've been watching her channel like crazy for the last couple months, ever since I discovered her. I love Italian food, love, love, love. But she doesn't only cook Italian, she cooks all kinds of food. And her recipes are really easy to follow. She's really personable and she's like really nice. So I'll leave her channel linked in the description box. She's has a huge channel, so it's not like she needs a plug for me, but I'm just telling you guys because I personally like her videos. So I will leave that in the description box. But Italian food is my favorite of all time. She does cook a lot of Italian because she is Italian, but like I said, she cooks other kinds of foods too. Laura Vitale is her name. And I also watch a lot of Donald. I can't remember his name, but he's got an adorable dog named Max, and he is like a YouTube chef kind of guy. I'll leave his, maybe I should do a video on my favorite YouTube channels so you guys can see all the stuff that I watch. I think I'll do that. But yeah, I really like to watch the cooking videos because I feel like they really help me because I'm not naturally inclined to cooking, so I feel like kind of help. But he's got a really nice personality, and his wife Sophie and his little dog Max, like I said, are so cute. They're such a cute little family, so I like to watch their vlogs and his cooking videos. So yeah. My voice, hopefully it doesn't completely go, and I hope I don't get all the way sick, but we'll see. I'll keep you guys updated. But this, and again, this kind of like car vlog thing, I feel like is me kind of forcing me, myself, to create more, even if it's just a dialogue between the two of us, or however many people are watching. Yeah, it's just a way that we can talk, and it's a way that I can create and get my voice out there, because I feel like I have a lot to say, but I don't always know how to say it. So we'll see. And I'll try and do more of these kind of impromptu if you guys like them. If you don't, I don't know. I just, I like talking to you guys, so hopefully you like them. But I'm gonna get off of here because I've already somewhat made it close to my mom's house, and nobody over there likes to be on camera, so I won't do that to them. They will hate me. You guys saw my sister in my ice skating vlog. She does not like to be on camera, so that's that. But I will see you guys soon. Thank you so much for watching, and yeah, leave me some comments in the comment section. Let me know what you guys think, how you feel about creativity and work stifling that shit.